Welcome back, everybody. And today we are here in episode 2 of season 0 of my world log. And today, as you can see behind me, I have picked up a couple of cats. Not a ton. You know, only just a handful. You know. They're just there, you know, chilling outside. Anyway, for the first half of this episode, as with every episode in this series, we're going to be taking a bit of a world tour to see what's changed over the past few episodes. So, for starters, I want to say it's 8 cats currently, and then, you know, more to come, because they keep spawning over at that village, and I keep taming them and bringing them home. Also, over here, as you can see, we have some bees. I went over to the other islands and grabbed all the beehives I can, or I could, totaling to 4, and I currently don't have any bottles on me, so I can't pick up the honey. But we have up to, or I guess we have in total, 10 hives, all full of bees, and of course that's how I've been getting honey blocks specifically, as well as a slime chunk I've found over there that we'll look at later. As far as farming is concerned, I found some pumpkins and melons, so I've been able to utilize those. Oh boy, the Enderman's gone and done it again. Got a dirt block in the tree. Lovely stuff. Okay. Anyway, as far as in the house is concerned, other than probably some wear and tear on my anvil, I've done a bit of enchantment on my tools. As you can see, I've gotten to netherite, because of course I've just done a ton of digging in the nether to farm up all of the tools that I don't currently have on me. Nothing on these floors except for the fact that, if it wasn't already in the last episode, I converted this furnace into a super smelter furnace. I guess mini... A super smelter light, that's what we'll call it. It doesn't even have a coal intake or a fuel intake, so I've just been putting that in manually. And of course, as you can see, I've put in 64 dried kelp blocks in every furnace here so that I can do all the smelting that I want. Of course, we also have the extra, what were these, 1.14 crafting stations? They're here, and I've used them. I've also done a little bit more resource gathering. I went to the Guardian Temple off Yonder Ways that was going to be in this episode until there was no sponge room, and it was just kind of content you've probably seen 100 times. So I decided just to restart the episode to now. Where I have 3 wet sponges. Let's go ahead and actually smelt those up. Let's save on fuel. Fun fact, oak planks, well actually any planks in general, smelt 1 item and a half, so 2 go to 3 smelts. Additionally, a little bit of creeper head extraction. How would you call that? Charged creeper blowing upage. Yeah. I'm going to overlay some... Hello there. This is not your house. Would you like to leave? I mean, I'll make you leave. Oh, nice. Got a gold block. Or a gold bar. Anyway, as I was saying, I was able to catch a thunderstorm and get 2 charged creepers to blow up 2 normal creepers. And as you can see, that is the footage being overlaid right now. So you can't even see what I'm looking at. I could be looking at a staircase right now and you wouldn't know. Wow, the magic of editing. Very interesting. Anyway, that is going to help me get my classic, I don't know if I would call it classic, but it's my Ice Face 42 banner, and be able to put that on my shield. So that should be in place by next episode once I figure out how to operate the loom, because currently I don't think I've even ever used a loom. Can you even craft banners in a crafting table anymore? I don't have a clue. Anyway, I've said anyway probably 5 times within the last minute. So, moving on, instead of anyway, let's go ahead and head over to the village. That is where the most notable development is. I don't need to be carrying around this stuff, but I'll put it away when I get back. Alright, let's go ahead and swim over there. I do believe I already had a kelp farm type area, just a manual kelp farm set up down here. As you can see, just a ton of kelp ready for me to break from the bottom. Alright, now if you were paying very close attention to last episode, you'll already be able to see significant changes to the village area. For instance, I removed this hill and added a couple slopes, or I don't know, pathways? Probably pathways is the proper term around the village. Oh, I need to. I don't have a shovel. Never mind. I've also added a few more villagers, or a few more lecterns and beds for more villagers. Once again, more pathways. And this is probably where the most drastic terraforming was done. Right here, this almost entirely was sand, including this half of the hill. And I've changed it to dirt, and it looks 20 times better. So, that is something that I got done. We have, I believe this was already here, the cow farm. And we did, or I did, make a slime farm down underneath. And as you can see, it's not complete. You can see a little bit of light peeking through there. It seems to be a little more clear on the recording. But down here is the middle pillar for a slime farm that is on 4 different chunks. I was able to find a 2x2 of slime chunks, and I'm currently trying to trade up enough glass to finish that dome before I start drying it out with the 3 sponges that I've been able to grab. But let's go ahead and look down here, because at this point, this area is basically a perimeter style area. Goes all the way down to bedrock, I guess minus or plus one level. As you can see, goes all the way down. You won't be able to see the bedrock because, of course, there's one layer of blocks, just so I can install some hoppers and magma blocks and stuff like that. And of course, I've been able to get a fair bit of slime out of this farm. I don't know where this rotten flesh came in, but it's going to stay down here forever because I don't care to bother putting it in my storage system. All right, let's go ahead and climb back up. I probably should have installed like a bubble stream to the bottom, but at this point, I've climbed this ladder over 100 times, and I don't care enough. Also, statistics-wise, let's go ahead and look at how many blocks I mined out, mostly without enchantments. Statistics is where? It's actually probably out here. Yes, statistics, items times mined. I've only mined 25,000 stone, probably about 80% without enchantments. So that was a fun time. But of course, in the end, I got it done enough to get 2 stacks of slime blocks, some of which is in my inventory right now. Now, for what I did with some of the other slime blocks, let's go ahead and head over to that island over there. Let's turn off my chunk borders. No, that's hitboxes. There we go. And I currently have not been using a boat to get between islands because, of course, I have Depth Strider, which is actually probably half the speed, but honestly, it's not worth the effort of finding my boat again. Oh, there it is. You can kind of see it on the horizon there. But let's go ahead, Enderman. Let's go ahead and put that back. There we go. Now, as we'll be able to see, we have significant, I mean, clearly significant progress on this island over here. Let's go ahead and swim in. there's an area over there that I wanted to show off that's under the water that I think would be good for a at least aesthetic build. I don't think I'm going to put anything functional over there just because there's no mob spawners or anything. Anyway, as you can see under this hill, we have a bomb factory. How does slime translate to a bomb factory? Well, we get sheep and we harvest all their wool with the combination of a tree farm. As you can see, I've already harvested a little for all my crafting. But right here, we have a fairly simple tree farm. Oh! Oh. Man, that honey was all farmed manually, and I probably lost some of it. On the plus side, this is a super easy thing to construct, but ugh. Ah. My disappointment is immeasurable, and my day is ruined. I've lost what? An observer? I should have some building blocks left over, actually. I don't believe I had a slime block there, so that's, or a slab on top of that redstone. This did have a, right? Because you do that and then it triggers the piston wall. I can fix the slime up, kind of. And I lost one honey block. That's not too terrible of loss. Yeah. Alright, well, we have most of a slime farm left over here for me to showcase a little bit. As you can see, for this layer, all we have that would interact with the sapling, the sapling's growth ability, I would rephrase that too, is this dispenser, and then everything else within its vicinity is wood, which is super useful because it means we use a lot less bone meal. Have some more bones in here for that. And like I was saying, this does before the creeper. I'm still kind of disappointed about that, but oh well, just because I have to swim back and forth with the resources. That's about the entire hassle of it. Anyway, super simple design. We just have two very simplistic piston walls that you can pretty much get the design of right here. It's just tiled upwards. That repeater back there is set to 3, and then there's a redstone dust in front of it. And that's basically the entire piston wall design. You can see there's redstone on the obsidian. And that's all there is to it. And then over here, if I go ahead and break some of these leaves and this stone as well, you can pretty much see the entire double piston extender design. This is a tree farm type double piston extender, which means it leaves this row of blocks one away from the piston so that the piston does not interfere at all with the growth of the what's it called? The sapling. Yeah. All right. So we have a double pulse of the redstone powering and then unpowering being detected by this observer and sent upwards. And that gets sent through this observer, pulsing the back repeater or back piston once for the power on, and then the lamp goes on. So that pulses the front piston once, then the lamp goes off from the observer here becoming depowered, which means that the delay, or the was that probably was in real life and not in the game. It sounded like a ton of blocks just got broken by a wither. Anyway, we have this redstone lamp that goes off, and then that triggers the front pistons again. Then we have the next line. There's a dog behind me. I don't know if you can hear that. It's kind of distracting. Hello, dog. I cannot help you. And I'm probably going to leave that in without cutting, because in the first half of the episode, I don't intend to do very many cuts unless there's long travel involved. All right, back to this redstone design that is more interesting than dog behind me making a fuss. You know, actually, I have stone. Or actually, I said actually twice in two sentences. Cool. I can just trigger it. Oh boy. That's something else broke. What is that something else? That should have triggered the design. Oh, the redstone that's in my inventory. All right. So trigger the design again. I'll try my best to get the observers in frame. So you can see, if you slow down the video, how the pulses go through that design. And of course, that's just tiled every two blocks for quasi-connectivity. That's probably a better, just looking at it is probably a better explanation than me trying to say this fire or this powers than this powers, but this the redstone lamp has a delay in it, so it doesn't power this piston too many times. So yeah, just slow it down and you'll be able to see how that design functions. And of course, I'll be making a video on this tree farm when it's. Oh boy, did something else blow up? Probably. Well, you can see that that piston wall works. But in the future, I will be making a video on this tree farm design when I have the time to do it. All right, anyway, did I mention that you combine the wool and the wood to make beds? And then beds are the high-powered explosives that I was talking about? Probably not, but I've mentioned it now. And of course, I don't think I need to go too into detail, but a simple wool farm like this is really quite efficient. You just cram a bunch of sheep in a hole. You point an observer at the grass block that they're eating from. Then, on top of that observer, you can kind of see the gray before that sheep moved its head, is another observer pointing into this dispenser, which points at the heads of the sheep. And so you just make this pattern of grass. And it means that the center grass block that they're eating off of will regenerate quite quickly. And because there's a lot of sheep in the pen, the probability is high that they will eat the grass right away, meaning that you have almost no delay and as high efficiency as possible. I think I could have increased efficiency by changing that glass block or this glass block for grass, leaving this as air and then putting glass here or a grass here. But I personally like the aesthetic that's going on here, so I did not opt for that solution. Plus, I think I would have had to put some sort of not so good looking transparent block instead of that glass. But anyway, that is the bomb factory, and I've made plenty of bombs, aka beds, here. And of course, that tree farm is powered by a skeleton spawner that you can see the tower into, or the bubble stream to. It's just a tower of kelp, that's why I use the word tower. Right over there. It's a far swim, so I'm not even going to attempt to do it. And if I recall everything, that should be everything that's happened in between episodes, recapped in one fairly messy take. But I'm not gonna cut it because I don't intend to cut on the first half or the world tour half of the episodes. So now we can get into the semi-interesting. topic for today. Of course, I say semi-interesting because you've seen it probably 100 times as a Minecraft content consumer. But today we will be fighting the Ender Dragon, hence why I have Eyes of Ender in my inventory. Alright, let's grab a little bit of slime. Here we go. That realistically should be enough for the purposes I intend it for. So let's just clear out our inventory. I can consider that gold sword smeltable. Ah, I have a smeltable bin here. And let's see, sponge goes into rare resources. There we go. And finally, oh yeah, here's all my other tools. We can grab all of the beds, or at least this many. I believe it takes 12 beds to kill the Ender Dragon, at least going off of what speedrunners use. Using beds to kill the Ender Dragon, of course, works off of the mechanic that beds explode when you try to sleep in them in the Nether or the End, and being specific to the Nether Ender Dragon. And of course, the pumpkin is in case I get chicken and, you know, don't want to bother with Enderman. Of course, in regular Minecraft, this shadow is a solid texture, but I'm just using a resource pack to make it semi-transparent, just because that's how I prefer to play the game. As well as the fact that my shield is lower on my screen as well. That's the same resource pack. Anyway, oh, I thought that was nighttime, but it's still daytime. We can head into the Nether. There has been next to no, not enhancements. What would it be called? Basically nothing new has happened in the Nether, other than a couple of tunnels being dug to various places, including where the end portal is, or the stronghold rather, which is where the end portal is. Anyway, we gotta climb up our staircase that I probably should have improved a while ago, but I'm keeping it this way. Hello there. All right, we run. Yeah, they're gonna handle that guy for me. I don't need to worry. Thanks. Alright, cool. Looks like I'm safe enough to make the trek over to where I need to go. Now, if I recall... Oh, wow, there's more hoglins. Okay. Let's take the long route around. This way goes off... Or these torches go off to another fortress, but... If I go this way, in this wall here, we have the entrance to the stronghold tunnel. And it's not particularly long, just because the stronghold spawns within a certain area near your spawn chunks. So I might as well not cut it out, or cut out this part of the video, so you can just see where I've been in the Nether and what's around. Alright, and as you can see, it's just right there. So now we can do the task I've done plenty of times, which is go to the End and fight the Ender Dragon. Oh no, my mouse is having a little bit of trouble responding. That's gonna be fun when I'm in the middle of the End fight. But it's probably fine. We'll get by. It's just a little extra excitement. Hello there. How do you do? Alright, and then right here... Oh well, I didn't... I guess my inventory was full of beds when I came here first. But now I actually have enough Eyes of Ender to get into this portal. So place that in there. And here, let's just throw that for fun. It went that way. Okay, well, I thought it was supposed to go to the center of the portal, but I guess not. So let's get water bucket on my inventory, and realistically, that should be everything that I need. All right, let's go. Let's see, am I in the middle of nowhere? Not yet. Or not currently. Or at all. I'm just under the island. Also, the reason I chose slime blocks here is because I can construct safety pillars out of them or safety Enderman coverings. Granted, slime blocks can be destroyed by the Ender Dragon, so I'm gonna want to at least have one permanent structure for hiding from Enderman. Anyway, let's go ahead and get to destroying the crystals. There's one. Wow, nice shot. By my part. Wow, okay. Right, he was attacked by the dragon. I'm getting low. Okay. Is that high? Oh, that was just to the left of it. That's low. Think that was to the left. Oh, I'm a tad bit low. All right, we'll try for this pillar. Wow, first shot. Okay. Probably should have grabbed some bottles for Dragon's Breath, but oh well. Where are the other crystals that I've missed? Oh, here's that mouse not responding. Now, I believe speedrunners aim into. Oh, hey, okay, that's strong stuff. I believe speedrunners just aim into the absolutely tiny gap. Let's get out of there. In the cage on the corners. I clearly am not a speedrunner. But I can try. I mean, if I shift, it might go through. No, I don't think I have a good angle. Let's go ahead and look through this corner, and here we go. A. All right, I don't know what is left. Oh, is that still left? It is. I don't think you can knock those back at the dragon. All right, what is left? What is right? What is in the middle? All very good questions. Oh boy, that's gonna be a pain jumping through. Is that it? I mean, he's not healing, so I guess that's it. Now, I probably want for this dragon breath to fade away. Oh, I just looked at him. Cool. Let's switch to sword. Come over to this side, my friend. And now, I can just slice you from the safety of the water. Oh, that's the dragon. Okay. Alright, now I should be able to do the speedrunner strategy by putting a block there, grabbing a bed, and then waiting for the Ender Dragon to circle. I'm gonna put that in my offhand. Oh, okay, okay. I mean, I don't think they changed that. Oh, maybe it cannot land? I don't know. I am not a speedrunner, as I've said. So, yeah, I'm just waiting for... get down here. Oh, and hello, mouse. Whoa! Crazy knockback. Oh, and there is one left from over there. Alright, let's get that one down. Or at least make an attempt. Whoa! Alright, pro Minecrafter strategy? I'm not a pro Minecrafter, apparently.
But it's probably fine. We'll get by.
Now I get to cut and just, you know, take the walk of shame all the way back. And back into the fray. I don't believe I installed a gravestone. Yeah, a gravestone data pack is just on my personal world. So everything's just on the floor here. Cool, and let's get somewhere semi-safe. So we can sort our inventory out. I only have 3 arrows left. That might not be a great time. But other than that, get some food, some slime blocks. Let's load our crossbow. And I suppose we'll just pillar up. It was the extra thick pillar, I do believe. I want to sit. Yes, it's that one. Okay. What? But it's probably fine. We'll get by. That was a bed. At least some of my stuff was netherite. The joys of intentional game design. Lovely. I just realized I cannot survive a single hit from the Hoglins, probably. Well, I mean, I made it back to the tunnel, so I'm probably safe by this point. Alright, take 3 of dying to intentional game design. Let's do it. I mean, let's not do it. Yeah. Alright, so I just gotta find the fire, and that's where my stuff's gonna be. In the flames, if any of it survived. Well, we got a bed. We got my sword, probably. Armor? Cool. Got another bed. Torches? I don't know why I brought those, but I have them. Alright, let's see what I recovered. Looks like my helmet and chest plate were burnt to cinders. Lovely. And my slime blocks as well. Great. Actually, no, I think... Wait, did I have slime? Yeah, I had slime blocks on me. So all the slime blocks that I brought with me burnt to a crisp. Lovely stuff. Anything else? Alright. Let's try this again. I'm probably safe here. And that is not a bed. I'm not placing beds under myself. Alright, now, oh boy. Oh, and I lost my food. Oh, no, no, I got food. Okay, cool. I at least have that. Get out of here. Get out of here. Okay. Keep going. Keep going. Alright. Take two of trying the pro strat. So you're supposed to wait. Oh, this is not going to work anymore. I want to say the strat is you're supposed to wait until the dragon starts circling, but before the dragon lands. I'm a terrible shot. Come on. You had to turn. Alright. Very compelling gameplay. Hey, I got one shot off. That's at least mildly helpful. Are you coming in yet? Doesn't look like it. Come on. Wait, what? Why am I walking? Oh, because I had my hand on the D key. That's why I'm walking. Yep, just moving. Oh, hey, that one hit. That was way to the right. Oh, wait, it looks like she's coming in. And my mouse is not working. Hello? Alright, that didn't work too well, but I got one hit in, at least. And I want to see if I can squeeze down here. There we go. Do I need to jump? I do need to jump. Now you just stay right where you are. That's a good spot. Or run away. And dodge at just the right moments. Be a mild annoyance. Ah, oh, I'm in a hole. Come around. Just gonna circle around that pillar. Alright, let's take the carved pumpkin off. Probably slightly easier to see things on video that way. Hey! Oh, it looks like you're coming down. Okay. And mouse, hello. Okay. Well, I got, you know, some of it. And now I just jump and swing my sword. And can this be the one? It cannot. That can be. There it is. That is the dragon fight. All done and dusted. Click that. And that'll teleport over here. And then I can... Oh, that's why I brought the torches. Minecrafter's instinct. Break it with the torch. Now I've got my trophy. And is this 100 levels? It's supposed to be 100 levels. The rest went through the portal, probably. And we have the credits. That, actually, I believe I already have a video of the credits on my channel from my first world. Now, it may just be me, but I'm pretty sure that it used to be the fact that every time you went through the nether or the end portal, it would play these credits. And then they made it so that it only plays the first time. I guess these aren't credits, but I mean, it's the end scroll, so. You can view these as long as they haven't changed in the past 7 years. As long as they haven't changed, you can view the whole credits on my channel. Just probably search Minecraft credits and it'll show up. But anyway, I can just hit the escape button and we can skip that. And we can go look for my experience, which is probably somewhere on the ground out here. Wherever world spawn may be. Oh, it's right here. So I'm just gonna, mark that. I'm gonna put the flower right here, because that's where it was. And there we go. We have a total of 65 levels. And I'm on fire. Alright, we have the dragon egg. Where should the dragon egg go? Where else would I put a dragon egg? But, oh wait, I'm on the wrong floor, and my mouse has been dying all day. Where else would I put my dragon egg but by my fancy chairs so that I can't see out the window from this chair? But I got a dragon egg, so it's all good. Alright. And that is really all I've had planned for the second half of today's episode, because of course the dragon fight is rather long, albeit mundane. But that's going to do it for today's episode. So like, comment, and subscribe, and I guess I have to remake my armor. And I will see you next time for a definitely fixed tree farm, and then over there on that island, I should also have an iron farm, plus I should have the slime farm over there all finished up as well.